NPA declined to prosecute or to go after Arthur Fraser, right? Over unlawful Zuma medical parole. There's an article from East Sunday World written by Umpo Koka on the 28th of June 2024. Right, this article speaks about the fact that others were saying, Fraser must be arrested for giving Zuma a medical parole before time. He must be arrested. You know what I'm saying? That's what others are saying. But the NPA, they were like, NPA. They were like, we will not prosecute the man, right? Why are we prosecuting the man? Like, what is it that he has done that warrants us to him and put him behind bars? No, we're not going to do that. Let me give you a context to this, to those that don't have a context. The context here is that there was a situation where Jacob Zuma get arrested, and you know what happened in the country. I don't even need to tell you. There was what we now call July unrest, where the malls were banned and a lot of things happened. During that time, Jacob Zuma went to serve whatever time in prison. Then he was released on what was called a medical parole. Fraser, being one of the key guy who facilitated that process. Now, the ones who are angry, who wants to use the state institution to make sure that anything that smells Zuma, it just gets flushed to the drain, right? That is what they want to do. They want to make sure anything that is named Zuma is dealt with appropriately. So now they are like, even Fraser must be arrested, right? The NPA responded on this one. As quoted here by Sunday World, we really need to go into details about this, provided that you are very keen, you are very interested, right? And I know, man, we need to talk about this, because we have seen people who whosoever supported Zuma, they suffered a lot. But Judge Tlope, they got removed. Why? Because they supported Jacob Zuma, right? So we know what happened to people who supported the former president Jacob Zuma. All those people will suffer a lot. We know it for a fact. But in this YouTube channel, there's one thing that I can promise you, that we know it for a fact, that you're not gonna suffer a lot if you do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
So let's go on. Let's proceed. Gauteng Director of Public Prosecution, NDPP, has declined to prosecute former state security agents, SSA, Director General Arthur Fraser, for allegedly defeating the ends of justice. The move came after forensic investigator Paul O'Sullivan opened a case against Fraser. O'Sullivan, guys, he was somewhere, I don't know he was accused of what, but not long ago, that man was accused of something. I just forgot what, but I would remember. When I do, I will tell you. Right. This was revealed on Friday by the National Head of Directorate for Priority Crime Investigation Hawks, Lieutenant Jen Godfrey Libia, announced this during a Hawks media briefing at the GCIS media offices in Hartford, Pretoria. Libia and his management team held a briefing to outline progress and take stock of milestones achieved for the period during fourth to the last quarter of the 2023-2024 financial year, January to March 2024. He spoke about the national priority of offenses deepening, right? They said the offenses ditching the Hawks success and high profile cases, right? I watched that press conference, but I did not follow up on some of the things as well. Right. Okay. So I'm not going to go into the other things that Libia said. I wonder, is this the same Libia that is supposed to come and testify in the Senzo Meiwa case? Here. Wait a minute. No. Is the one who's supposed to come and testify in the Senzo Meiwa case is a retired one? I don't know. But is it Libia? I think it's General Libia. I think Naye is a retired and was a member of Hawks. Huh? I still need to do my things. I still need to check. But yeah. One thing that I wanted us to look into, one thing that I wanted us to focus on was the fact that there seems to be this constant and deliberate attack on people that support former President Jacob Zuma. We all know and we can see. We see it for what it is and for what it was. I mean, honestly speaking, guys, there is something wrong with how things are transpiring so far as the former President Jacob Zuma is concerned, in terms of people who are associated to him just get, look, they constantly get threatened. They suffer a lot as well. So yeah, I wonder. I'm just wondering if this was not one of the situation where the attempt to get Uata Fraser arrested, was it not part and parcel of such a strategy to intimidate, or it's not even intimidation, guys. I'm just wondering if it was not a strategy to punish people that doesn't support Ramaphosa, rather punish them by making sure that they get arrested. So I often wonder if that is not maybe one of the things that one should be worried about. I'm just concerned. I must say, I'm concerned that I hope this was just a genuine approach to this. Because it is pointless to use the state organs to pursue things that are not of public interest and are not of the interest of justice, but are the interest of politics. It's just one of those things that you sit there and you're like, I hope, and I just hope, it's not one of those moves where we have seen it in the past when we are aware of those shenanigans where some people get prosecuted, not necessarily because they've done anything wrong, in a sense of the word wrong, but just because of affiliation and association, then other people get punished. And we just hope the move to want to arrest Uata Fraser, it's really not one of those